way out. All rise. Probate Court of Fulton County is now in session. The Honorable Judge Pinkie T. Toomer presiding. Court come to order.
Good morning. You take your seats.
We're here this morning on the estate of Graciela Alvarez, deceased, estate number 223254, and the estate of Federico Alvarez, deceased, estate number 223354. Thank you. The court has in front of it a number of matters. But essentially a final settlement of accounts that includes a request for extraordinary compensation, a request to be discharged, etc., and objections to some of those. Now, we've had a brief pretrial conference, so I know that we have the petitioner, the administrator, Mr. Walter Hamburg, present, Mr. Spears, his counsel, Ms. Kingry, good to see you, and your attorney, John Barrett, and Mr. Freddie Alvarez. At the pretrial conference, we spoke briefly about how I thought we should proceed. And essentially, I've got to hear and make sure I have all of the information related to any potential objections regarding the settlement that includes attorney's fees, extraordinary compensation, etc. So whatever the allegations are regarding what has or has not been done, I need to hear today. Now, I think, based on what we talked about, that we're going to start with the petitioner and the petition for final settlement, because that will cover a number of the things that are before the court. I would be inclined to hear from the petitioner first, to hear from Mr. Freddie Alvarez second, and then hear from Ms. Kingry, if that works. And we can modify as we need to, because I'm going to hear it all anyway. Let me get first all of those who may give testimony sworn. So I need Ms. Kingry to stand, Mr. Alvarez, Mr. Hamburg. Will everybody stand? Let's be sworn, because you will be giving testimony. Okay, after we're sworn, you can invoke the rule. Do you have some others who, okay, let's see, Mr. Deutsch. Others who may give testimony today, I'd like to get you sworn. Oh, yeah, we can do that.
Ms. Herrera, and she's not here yet.
Okay, they'll be sworn later. Raise your right hand, please. Do you each solemnly swear or affirm that the testimony and information you will give before this tribunal will be the truth, the whole truth, to help you God? Do you so swear or affirm?
Yes.
Excellent. Thank you. All right, we've already had a request to invoke the rule. So other than parties who are present, I will ask anyone who is here on behalf of one of the parties as a witness to please stand outside and wait to be called. You should not discuss your testimony.
So that would be me.
Except with the attorneys. You certainly don't discuss it with each other. So if you are potentially a witness, please step outside and be called in one at a time. I understand we may have, did we ever get the amendment? Some that will just read from file. Then I'm going to ask if there are any motions for this time.
Your Honor, the clerk asked me to bring the original.
Okay, good.
Did we hand deliver a service copy to you?
Yes.
That's map road.
No, please. All right. And these are amendments to petitions that are already before the court. Thank you. Okay. Do we have a motions at this time.
Your Honor, I'm John Spears for Walter Hamburg. I do have a brief motion on the part of what's before the court is relating to the fact that my client had early on had filed a petition for a petition to resign in both states. It became apparent at some point after we had the declaratory, there were objections to his resignation from Mr. Alvarez. There were other pleadings that seemed to say, we don't want to discharge from liability. And there was an objection to voluntary dismissal. I think voluntary dismissal is real clear under the Civil Practice Act, which applies to these courts. 9-11-41, voluntary dismissal can be made at any time before the witness is sworn. You know, there's this whole thing about the counterclaim rule. If somebody's objecting to you, you can't dump the case. You can't take the case out from under them by dismissing it. That couldn't happen here because we're here to talk about the things like all of Mrs. Kingler's complaints about what she thinks Mr. Hamburg did or didn't do. So his dismissal of his position to resign has caused no harm. It's perfectly legal. And we think that that settles about three of the issues that are before the court in the style of this case.
All right. Mr. Barrett, do you have any response?
Your Honor, I don't use this word on it. I think it's limited. He's here. He has to be dismissed, and you're going to make a ruling today. So I think that issue is really being made moot by the fact that we're moving forward.
I think you're both saying the same thing. I agree. And I did note, just for my own review, that objecting to the voluntary dismissal was not something that was going to be heard. Moot. I agree. All right, can we move on?